Hello everyone, welcome to today's session. Today I am here with the contents of medulla oblongata. The medulla oblongata is a funnel-shaped structure that constitutes the terminal portion of the brainstem. Location: it resides in the posterior cranial fossa below the tentorium cerebelli. Function: the medulla regulates many of the vital functions of human body, including respiration, heart rate, and blood pressure. Regarding its role in the circulation of blood throughout the body, the medulla oblongata works with the nucleus of the solitary tract. Arterial supply: the vertebrobasilar system is responsible for supplying the medulla oblongata with arterial blood. The posterior inferior cerebellar artery is a branch of vertebral artery before it gives its contribution to the anterior spinal artery. It provides direct branches that supplies the dorsolateral region of the medulla oblongata. The anterior inferior cerebellar artery branches from the basilar artery, which is formed by the union of the two vertebral arteries. It provides slender pins to the upper medulla. The anterior spinal artery, which is formed by two anastomosing branches of each vertebral artery, supplies the medial medulla. Venous drainage: there are several main venous drainage routes for the medulla oblongata. The petrosal vein is one such vessel. It will end up draining to the superior petrosal sinus. Both the anterior and anterolateral medullary veins drain into the corresponding spinal veins inferiorly. There are also anterior and posterior median medullary veins that travels along their respective sulci to drain the medulla. Clinical aspects: medulloblastoma. The major pathological concerns of the medulla oblongata have to do with the compression or destruction of the associated tracts that transverse the conduit and the nuclei that resides in its substance. Several conditions such as tumors, hydrocephalus, vascular accidents, and trauma can affect the contents of the caudal brainstem. One example of tumors of the medulla oblongata is medulloblastoma. This is a primitive neuroectodermal tumor, accounting for about 20% of the pediatric brain neoplasms. Other than disrupting the integrity of the tracts and nuclei present, this is a highly metastatic tumor that fortunately responds well to radiotherapy. Another chief concern with these masses is the likelihood of obstructing the foramina of the fourth ventricle, which would result in hydrocephalus, that is increased water in the brain and consequently increased intracranial pressure. Lateral medullary syndrome of Wallenberg. The vascular insults to the arterial supply of the medulla can result in a lateral medullary syndrome of Wallenberg. In this situation, occlusion of PICA of the vertebral artery can result in the following clinical vignettes, like random eye movement, nausea, vomiting and dizziness, loss of pain and temperature senses to the ipsilateral face, lack of voluntary coordination of movement with respect to gait and movement of the ipsilateral side, and an inability to swallow and speak. So that's all for today. See you on tomorrow.